Good evening, Commissioners. My name is Donald Dixon. I live just outside of Washington. Donald Lay said about everything I needed to say. Really, I'm going to just sit down. Nah, just kidding. Had two things I wanted to briefly talk about, both of them concerning the jail. One, every time I hear you bring up the jail, I feel like I'm listening to Nancy Pelosi say, you got to pass it before you can see what's in it. I think there's too many things, too many logistics that are going to cost the county money in putting the jail on either side of the river, anywhere but behind the courthouse. You've got transportation expenses. You've got, what are you going to do with a magistrate? You're going almost have to have two different magistrates working, which means you're going to have four different magistrates working swing shifts, unless you're going to bring prisoners back and forth, which brings up safety issues for not only the prisoners, but the officers doing the transporting and the citizens alike. There's just a lot of questions that haven't been answered, just like Donna Lay said. And I think all of them are costing us money, whereas if you look closer at putting it on this property behind the courthouse, we'd do away with a lot of those things. Secondly, a lot of commissioners have talked about, some of them even, Gary, I believe you brought up, oversight committees when you were running for commissioner. The only reason you need oversight committees is when you've got somebody not doing their job. The sheriff's office has not been doing their job. I mean, this is obvious. We've been given misinformation for years how bad the jail was, and actually it was just where they weren't doing any kind of maintenance on it. I mean, who's going to leave the hot water shower head running 24 hours a day, wasting money for weeks on end? I certainly wouldn't do it in my house, and I would expect there to be some kind of mold or something involved. The reason they do that, folks, is to make things as bad as they can make them so they can come to you crying they need money or they need more people. They've done it before. This isn't the first time. They used to send out letters, I guess they still do, about investigations. This is just, I call it Department of Misinformation. You're not going to get a true answer from anybody over there, and this is some of the games they play. I would guarantee you, look, in 15 months, we're going to have a new sheriff anyway. This is poor management is what we're talking about. It's not, the jail's been there over 40 years. We've never had to empty the jail before until now, other than hurricanes. But when they do that, it's a short-term thing, and the state comes and gets them. We don't have to do it. Even if we do, it's a short-term thing. People complain about how much money they've had to spend housing these prisoners for all these weeks. That's nothing compared to what the jail is going to cost us. You build it on the other side of the river at $20 million plus, you still got $1.5 million more in just upkeep and personnel that you don't have now. That's going to come due every year. You're costing us money. You're not doing us a service. I would guarantee you that whoever else inherits this jail could make the one down here work. I know I could. Don't build one. I'll make the jail we've got work. Thank you very much.
Wow. Thank you.